Well, here's my new project. After it's been 35 plus degrees in Germany for about a week now, and I live right under the roof, I decided I had to have a desk fan. And being me, of course, it had to be an old one. It wasn't in as good a shape as it is now when I got it. Things I did before I started videoing was chrome plate the basket around it, because it was painted with some old white paint which was flaking off, so I took it to the wire brush and completely cleaned it out and sent it away to be chrome plated. And at my workplace I made these brass fan blades, because the old ones out of steel were just completely pitted and rusted and partly had holes in them. It is running, and it's running quite well actually, but it has just one speed, which is a little bit of a disadvantage, because that speed of course is full power and you don't always want full power. So what I'm going to be doing in this video series is renew the paint on here. As you can see, it's quite flaky and it seems to have been green once, I don't know. I'm going to take it completely apart and clean it. I'm going to fit an electric speed control so that I can vary the speed stepless. So let's start off by taking it apart and see how much grit and grime is inside. Critters, luckily. So, you know, a whole lot of just solid grease and hardened up dust. You can see the remainders of the green paint. I don't know why would you do that, but well, sometimes it may be fashionable. So we're going to try and clean up all the grit out of here. The coils are not burnt in any places, that's just, you know, black grease or what. This is the bottom side, so I guess all the oil would have run down here. So what we're going to do is basically clean all this shit out of here, and we're going to put the wire brush to this. I hope that it's going to take off the paint as well, because it's quite chippy in some places. Like here you can see many places it has always already worn off, and I can actually rub it off with my fingernail, so I'm pretty confident. The whole thing is out of aluminium. The only heavy part is of course the iron core here, but these things, they're just completely lightweighted. Bad thing about that is I will have to be very careful when I start drilling this to fit the speed control unit, because old aluminium starts to get brittle over time, so we may run into problems there. But as far as it goes now, pretty straightforward, cleaning it out, getting the paint off. Thank you. the paint is going off pretty quickly. The only things that limit me is the power of my wire brush motor and the fact that this is aluminium, because obviously I don't want to score it in any ways. Making this thing took me barely 10 minutes, so I guess I'm going to be through this quite quickly. And while I polish the others, I'm going to prime this one already, so I can coat it after that. So here it is, prepared for painting. I just hung it up by a wire, and I plugged the bearing openings with two screws so that no lacquer can get in there. So while the paint is drying, I am going to modify this thing a little bit. That looks better, doesn't it? Tougher on this part, so I chuck it up in the lathe and just use some sandpaper. And that's working pretty good. So here's what the blank rest looks like. Looked kind of cool. Thought I'd show this before. Let's get primed. Well, the can of primer is empty and all parts are primed. It's getting late, so I'm going to let these sit overnight, and then tomorrow is going to be the big day of black paint. By the way, the wicks that were in the oilers for the bearings, I'm soaking them in a mixture of rust remover and alcohol so that all the grit and dirt can get out of them. If we cannot reuse them, then I still have some wick left over from repairing those two. So, that's it for the day, and also what's left is a little bit of soldering to modify the circuit board to fit under here, and we're going to have to drill some holes from the inside to mount the thing later. But that's it for today. Okay, so the pieces are now all painted. I will go over with some clear paint over this piece and this one here. And the next step will be then assembling the ordeal. If I didn't care, than words can say. So, unfortunately I didn't have enough battery to film the reassembly, but all in all it was just, you know, taking it apart in reverse. So, as you saw in the photo, I also mounted the PCB below. I had to drill and tap a hole to mount the transistor to monitor the voltage. Yeah, it turned out to be pretty nice, and it's also balanced alright. So I'll start it up here. And you can hear it's actually very quiet while running, barely makes any noise. And you can regulate the speed on it pretty good. And the wicks that were in the oil cups are actually still fine, so I could reuse those, and yeah, pretty decent desk fan.
Darling, if this isn't love, then why do I thrill so much? And what is it that makes my head go round and round while my heart just stands still so much?
If I didn't care, would it be the same? Would my every prayer begin and end with just your name? And would I be
okay, so that's about it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and thanks for watching.
Would all this be true if I didn't care for